Good morning, everyone. Good morning. It's time to start the Lord's Day, the first day of the week. September 13th, today. It's rainy, chilly, it's like fall. Food and leaves will start falling, change colors in fall. Ooh, pretty design when they change colors. It'll be like a painting, natural painting. You see how wonderful God's creation is. It's time now to worship the Lord. And together we praise the Lord in song. Near, near, my God, near to you, I want. Near you, no matter maybe suffer, be near you. Truly my song continues. I want near my God to you. I want near my God to you. I want near you. You show me the way that leads to heaven. All things you give me, you have mercy on me. The angels call me. I want near my God to you. I want near my God to you. I want near you. The morning I wake up, I think I must praise you. While terrible grief, I continue to worship you. Then my sorrow leads me. I want near my God to you. I want near my God to you. I want near to you. We want to be near to God. Our hearts are motivated. We don't forget God. It's important that we have time with God. Today is Sunday. We want to be near to God, not far from Him. We want to stay always near to Him every day. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Every day, every week, we search for His glory. Many people want to know more about God. The omniscience of God. Omni. Do you know what this means? It means all knowing. All knowing. God knows everything. In the Old Testament and in the New Testament, it talks about God being all-knowing. This is from Isaiah 40, 13 to 14. No person told the Lord's Spirit what he should do. No person told the Lord how to do the things he did. Did the person teach the Lord to be fair? Did any person teach the Lord knowledge? Did any person teach the Lord to be wise? No. It wasn't needed. People helped. the Lord already knew these things. Isaiah 40:28. The Lord made all the faraway places on earth. The Lord lives forever. He made the earth. He wasn't tired. He didn't have to sit down and rest. But he made everything in one day. Different people, their hearts and minds. All over the world are not the same. Yes, all over the world. Psalm 147:4-5. He counts the number of stars. A lot of stars. It's all over the world. He knows everything. Great is our Lord, and mighty in power. His understanding is infinite. Understanding. He knows everything. He's equal with God. He's gifted. Equal with God. Today we have computers. Some people are good with computers. Psalms 139:1-4. God is, Lord, you test me. You know all about me. He knows all the places. He knows every person. There are billions of people all over the world. But Jesus knows them all, the good and the bad. Sit down. You know when I get up. You know when my thoughts are from far away. I'm thinking. You know what I'm thinking. Lord, you know where I am going and when I'm lying down. You know everything I do. Lord, you know what I want to say even before the words leave my mouth. He knows before we say what we're going to say. We respect him. We don't want to do bad things. We live good. We see right. I Matthew 6, 5 through 6, NIV. When you pray, don't be like the hypocrites. The hypocrites love to stand in the synagogues and on the streets corner and pray loudly. They want people to see them pray. I tell you the truth. They want people to see them pray. Jesus said, I tell you the truth. They already have their full reward on earth. The people who pray know what to do. Those who are proud show prayer. They want people to look at them. They want attention. They want people to look at them because they want attention. They don't connect to God. When you pray, you should go into your room and close the door. Then pray to your Father who can't see you, your Father that cannot be seen. Your Father can see the things that are done in secret, and He will reward you. We go to the church meetings and we pray and fellowship. And if we go outside and we want to see people watching us, we don't have to pray long. We can pray short prayers. We can pray humble prayers. This shows that no one, no neighbor, person, Luke 12:7, that the very hairs of your head he can count the hairs on your head. He doesn't lose count. Don't fear. Therefore, you are of more value than many sparrows. He loves people, and He knows all about people. This lesson, the implications show truly the work that's involved in connecting all these things to God. God doesn't need to learn anything. He already knows. We graduate, we go to work, or we go to college, and we learn some more. And the time goes fast. Matthew 6:8-32. Therefore, do not be like them, for your Father knows the things you have need of before you ask Him. He knows before you ask Him. God already knows. But we pray. We talk to Him. Father knows the things you have need of before you ask Him. We seek our Heavenly Father. He's kind to all, not just the Jews, but to both the Jews and the Gentiles. He's kind to all people. The Jews belong to God, but we were not His. And then Jesus came and the gospel spread, and He accepted all people to join the Jews, and the Gentiles were joined together in Jesus. There is no place to hide from God. Psalms 139:12. Indeed, the darkness shall not hide from you, but the night shines as the day. The darkness and the light are both alike to you. We see the dark, and we see the light. We see the light, and when it's dark, we can't see, but God can see. He rules always. Dark, night or dark, He rules everything. He knows everything. But Jesus would know not to trust Himself to confront you all men. He did not need man's testimony about man, for He knew what was in a man. He knew, Jesus knew, He explained, He knew their lives. He knew their circumstances. He knew their pride. He knew those who were against Him. He knows every person. He knows to let people share about God. He knows everything. So we go ahead and we pray to Him. We show in our hearts that we want God's help. You tell to God. This is Ecclesiastes 12:14. For God will bring every work into judgment. We know God has secrets. Is that impossible? Every work that's done is for good or for bad. We want all of our work to be for good. We finish the good things. The Lord judges the bad things that we do. He judges. He's fair to all. And in Jeremiah 17:10. But I am the Lord, and I can look into a person's heart. I can test a person's mind. I can decide what each person should have. I can give each person the right payment for the things he does. The Lord can do. He knows and he can do all of these things. He can punish or he can give us eternal life. We know in our hearts. We witness to people near us. We witness to people who look nice, and there's some who think, what? Is that person good or bad? The confidence of his wisdom. First Corinthians 1:18-21. People are lost, not living in Christ. Why, they ask, what for? You'll die and be destroyed in hell. The cross is for all people. People believe. This verse, Isaiah 12:11. Paul wrote this. I will destroy the wisdom of the wise people, of the clever people. God's way was the cross, and people were foolish. Not to believe. Wise people were destroyed. Where is the wise person? Where is the educated person? Where is the philosopher of this time? God has made the wisdom of the world foolish. He let them be wise, yes. He chose them to be wise. But some people are foolish. God is wise. This is what God, with his wisdom, wanted. The world did not know God through the world's own wisdom. So God used the message that sounds foolish to save the people that believe it. The wise don't live in God. We notice they often follow and think that saved people sound foolish. They look at us and they say we're foolish. But we're wise when we are saved and serving God and trusting him. In Romans 11:33, oh, the depth of the riches, both of the wisdom and knowledge of God. How unsearchable are his judgments and his ways past finding out. The wisdom, he has both wisdom and knowledge. riches in the same person indeed. Yes, God's riches are very great. God's wisdom and knowledge have no end. No person can explain the things God decides. No person can understand or explain God's ways. No person can understand how God's Spirit, how. It's hard to explain. We know that He is everything in our lives. We believe and we trust that Jesus came and that he became human, but He was from God. He shows us in the Bible the verses that helps us understand. He knows and His wisdom is beyond us. In the Old Testament, there are verses about His wisdom that we can't be equal to Him. God knows everything. We can't be equal to Him. We are limited. The comfort of His knowledge. In Malachi 3:16-18, God's followers spoke with each other, and the Lord listened to them. There is a book in front of Him. In that book are the names of God's followers. Those are the people that honor God's name. The Lord said, these people belong to Me. I will be kind to them. A man is very kind to his children that obey him. In the same way, I will be kind to My followers, to the believers. You people will come back to Me, and you will learn the difference between good and evil. You will learn the difference between a person that follows God and a person that does not. We learn to be kind and trusting. And we learn, and He comforts us. In Psalms 56:8, You number My wanderings, put tears into Your bottle. Are they not in Your book? This sentence is difficult to understand. Number My wanderings, put My tears into a bottle? Are they not in Your book? This is maybe not clear, and the EBD will help us understand. You know I am very upset. You know how much I have cried. Surely You have kept an account of all my tears. He knows how much we've cried. He counts our tears. We've never tried to count our tears. We know that He comforts us when we are pressured, when we cry. God forgives us. He loves us. He died for us. We are His, and He knows, and He comforts us. The all-knowing God. Reverence. Reverence. He knows everything. We lift Him high. We can't run away from God. We can't hide from God. He will see us, even in the dark. We can't see in the dark, but He can see us. Confidence in God. He keeps us if we trust Him. Comfort. He comforts us when we are weak, when we are suffering. He gives us comfort for the things we need. He gives us everything to all people. Some people ignore God. They ignore Him. But we are ready for the Lord. He can bring us back to the Lord. We reverence Him. And it's important that we trust Him. And we see through His Word, through the Bible. We use the Bible and we read. That helps us trust Him. And He comforts us every day. Let's join in a song. Come, every person with sin burden, accept mercy from the Lord. He truly gives you peace. How? Trusting in His Word. Only trust Him. Only trust Him. Only trust Him now. He can save you. He can save you. He can save you now. Jesus gives His precious blood. Why? Bless us much. Believe now. Receive Jesus. He cleanses white compared as snow. Only trust Him. Only trust Him. Only trust Him now. He can save you. He can save you. He can save you now. Yes, Jesus truly, truth and way, lead you into rest. Believe Him, not postpone, then you become truly happy. Only trust Him, only trust Him, only trust Him now. He can save you, He can save you, He can save you now. Come, join with Jesus, then truly go to heaven. Live there, beautiful place, happy forever, continue. Only trust Him. Only trust Him. Only trust Him now. He can save you. He can save you. He can save you now. We thank Him for knowing us and that we can read and understand and know about His creation in the earth, the first, second, third, fourth, fifth day, and how He put things right and into place. It's so wonderful. We can't explain that. God knows everything. Next week we will have another lesson. We'll have three lessons, and I'll explain what next week, where and how, and all these different things. Let's pray together. Loving our Father in heaven, we all thank you for your blessings together here, that we can share about your omniscience. We know that you are all-knowing. Thank you for your kindness and your comfort. And thank you for helping us to look up and honor and reverence you. That we can think through all over the earth. We know in our hearts that we want to learn more about you. You make us want to learn more. We want to continue so we can be satisfied in your word. We seek your word. And we are humble. We know you through Christ. We know we can't hide from you. We're open. Christ came to show us. It wasn't a secret. It was open. So that we could know about you through Christ, and we praise you. Thank you for forgiving us and being with us every day as we continue through the week. Keep us safe and protected. In Jesus' name, amen. Bless you for your time to watch and join with us as we share God's word.